Hey guys, I'm Holly from The Run Experience. Today I am reviewing the Hoka Challenger ATR 3s. I've spent several months in this shoe and I've got all the specs on it for you. What I liked, what I didn't like. Let's get into it. All right guys, so I want to get started with the construction of this shoe. If you ever run in Hokas before, you know that they're known for their cushioning and, you know, pretty intense support down here. I've gotten used to that, but if you're not used to it, that's going to be something with all of their shoes that's going to take a little getting used to. As far as this shoe particularly, it is a trail shoe. They actually took their Clifton model, which was a road shoe, and turned it into a trail shoe. So the bottom, the outsole, is going to be super grippy. There are 3mm lugs down here, super, super tight to the trails. I never felt like I was slipping on anything wet or dry. As far as the midsole, cushioned and everything like their normal shoes, you know, I felt like there was a lot between me and the ground. So all the rocks and roots and stuff, I was definitely protected from those. As far as the upper, super breathable. Again, they used kind of the design from that Clifton. I felt like a lot of air getting to my feet and everything. And they also made it a little bit wider so my foot could situate in there nicely. The only problem I had with the design was the lacing. It was a little short. I'm someone who likes to do a heel lock in my running shoes, and I felt like I barely had the space to do that. But I did notice that in the newer model of this shoe, they did make those laces a little bit longer. In the next section, I'm going to talk to you guys about how it ran and how it felt. All right, guys, so let's get into the fit and feel of this shoe, how it ran. Like I said, I have spent several hundred miles in this shoe between racing ultra distance all the way down to my shortest 3 to 5 mile runs on the road. So been both on trail and road in this guy, and it definitely held up on both. As far as the feel, I felt very nicely stuck to the ground on trails, whether it was wet and muddy or like kind of loose dirt underneath. I feel like these lugs really held up and kept me, especially on the curves, tight to the ground. As far as cushion and support, on the roads, after, you know, 10 plus miles on pavement, I still felt well supported in these, and I've always felt that way about Hokas. So these do the same thing, even though they're their trail shoe. As far as the fit arounds here and, you know, blisters and all of that stuff, they actually have a no-sew cushioning inside of here, so making it really, really hard for you to rub up against in there, especially if you have good socks on. So, like I said, these fit great on the trail and road, and they boast a really good versatility across the board. All right, guys, so I just want to finish with my overall likes and dislikes of this shoe. Obviously, if I run this much in it, I have way more likes than I have dislikes. This shoe has supported me across a bunch of different terrains. In fact, I did a really long 50K race last weekend in complete mud and water up to my knees, and this shoe held up, shockingly. So that was awesome. My only dislike with this shoe is that on some of the drier days on the trails, you know, sometimes with this much, you know, height off the ground, it can be a little tricky when stuff gets technical. There's been a couple times with, you know, rocks and limbs and stuff, if I wasn't thinking about picking my feet up, I felt like these guys are so stuck to the ground that if I'm not picking up quick enough, I could trip or roll my ankle a little bit. That just takes getting used to. I've gotten used to it, but that's definitely just one thing to look out for. Otherwise, shoe's good. This shoe costs $150, which is standard for Hoka, but you know, if you're looking for something specific to trail or specific to road, you might find a little lower price point. Because this does both, I would say it's about fair and it's standard for them, and it's held up for a long time for me. So yeah, that's the Hoka. I've spent several months in this shoe and I really like it, but I do have, but it has a little bit more trail feel to it. Oh, let me start over. It is a trail shoe. Of course it does. All right, guys, remember that the best way to get into a pair of running shoes is to check out your local running store. I am at A Runner's Mind in San Francisco Bay Area, which is an awesome place to go if you're around here. They have a ton of shoes, a lot of great knowledge around them, so a great place to check them out. If you can't get to your local running store, make sure you go to runningwarehouse.com. Tons of good shoes on there as well, with a lot of in-depth reviews on the site so you know what you're getting into. If you liked this video, make sure you hit the like button down below. If you have any comments or questions for me, anything I didn't quite cover on this, make sure you drop that there. And then make sure you subscribe to our channel. We have way more than just reviews coming out. Run tips, marathon training, 5K training, nutrition videos, all that good stuff on there. So make sure you subscribe. Otherwise, I'll catch you guys in the next video.